how about driving to a crowded city on a Friday afternoon and desperately wanting to get to the edge of town? How about doing it without further waiting? We are here to help you with our Yutraffic Office configuration tool. Apart from the main purpose, where a single intersection is completely configured, our application can also be used to define an entire network of configurations and their corresponding connections. This serves as a basis for defining the so-called green wave. The green wave ensures that potential users of the intersection can smoothly pass through it due to a synchronization with other intersections among the same network. In the following video, we will work with two predefined intersections and we will connect them towards the green wave. We start our demo in the main window of the Yutraffic Office application. A prerequisite for the creation of a network of intersections is to switch to the corresponding perspective, the so-called network planning. This means that editors relevant to network planning will be visible. Now, let's navigate through the following project tree. Before the demo, I prepared a blank network which I called Network of Simplicity. There is only one version included in this network where I will go through all the steps towards a proper network configuration. I call the network version Sample Network. Within this network version, I am going to use only a few of the editors which are essential for creating the green wave itself. Let's start in the so-called intersection assignment editor, where we assign two intersections towards the network definition. Specifically, we always assign a corresponding intersection version. Now, we move to the so-called network definition editor, where we adjust both intersections to a background. Another step we need to take here is to establish so-called outward and return directions between these two intersections. As we start with the outward direction, we will be prompted with a dialogue where we are deciding about two parameters. The first parameter is about a source lag, means the lag from where signal groups, usually cars, are leaving the first intersection. And the second parameter is about a target lag, means the one where cars are arriving to the second intersection. After that, we are prompted about the distance between those intersections, specifically between their main direction stop lines. The value here is predefined and it reflects a proper settings being previously configured elsewhere. We continue by pressing Yes button in the following dialog, which considers the return direction. Once the return direction is established, we will proceed to creation of the so-called segment. The segment involves certain signal groups relevant for an upcoming green wave definition. To create a new segment, one needs to switch to the so-called segment mode via a dedicated toggle button. We need to start again with the first intersection. When right-clicking the intersection circle, Start Segment option will be the way we will go. Consequently, we right-click the second intersection and select Manually Create Return Direction. There is also another option for an automatic return direction. This option is used only for a case where the intersection's conflict points are not different for each of the two directions. This can usually happen when there is just crossing conflicting with the main direction. When we go with the manual return, it means we need to right-click the second intersection again to explicitly select the return direction. Finally, we end the loop by selecting the following context menu option back on the first intersection, End Return Direction. Then, a wizard pops up, where signal groups out of both intersections should be selected, means they are assigned for the eventual green wave. It is also possible to select a public transport signal groups, such as trams or buses, but in my case there are none of them defined in any of the intersections. I need to select K2 signal group for the first step of the wizard, as it is the signal group where the whole green wave process will start. K2 is the main direction signal group of the first intersection, which is used for the outward direction. For the second intersection, this kind of signal group is represented by FV1. This leads us to the return direction, where the signal group, which reflects the start of the opposite main direction, is FV3. Finally, we end the loop by selecting K1, which reflects the return direction sequence. Segment is created. Now we save changes here in the network definition editor, so the segment would be stored in our project. Before configuring the newly created segment further, I'm changing its name to Main Direction, because for both included intersections, it is about their corresponding main directions where we are about to create the green wave. Among other editors, the segment also includes the so-called time distance diagram editor, where I can directly set and visualize the green wave itself. Let's check a corresponding green wave in the so-called time distance diagram. I will define the cycle time, which will then be decisive in the selection of so-called signal programs. So, I right-clicked in the space intended for the future diagram and selected the context menu item intended for the placement of signal programs. I continue by selecting the programs themselves. One important condition applies here. The signal programs intended for the green wave must have the same cycle time. So, for each of the intersections, I choose a program with a cycle time of 90 seconds to match the settings for the total cycle time, which I set recently for the whole diagram. Of course, it is necessary to have the corresponding programs suitably prepared. Once the selection of the programs is complete, we can activate the green wave display via L star button above the diagram in the upper toolbar. The outward green wave direction is represented with green areas, while the blue areas represent the backward direction. Below the diagram, we can see corresponding signal group labels. Yes, those signal groups we assigned in the segment wizard. Those vertical black lines aligned with the labels are showing where each of those signal groups is having its stop line. We shift with the green areas using the green tick line on the stop line itself. The goal is simply to find the right perspective so as many cars as possible can make it through the green wave. As a check, we can visualize a trajectory of a single car to see how far it can make it through the network of those two intersections with no waiting time on the red light. First, I will activate the corresponding visualization via T star button above the diagram in the upper toolbar. We will deactivate the green wave areas for now, so it's not distracting us from what we want to check. I will now right-click the stop line of K2 of the first intersection, and then selecting Create PV Trip, Main Direction Outward, as a kind of a trip through the green wave itself. It is clear that for the certain trip of a single car, it is possible to reach the second intersection in time to catch the green light. But if starting a bit later, it's no longer possible. So the car needs to wait until the red light ends. When we go to properties of that car trip, we will see there is so-called lost time of 4 seconds. Means the car has to wait that long until the green light for the second intersection gets on.